Ya.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh.
wabarakatuh.
Okay, thanks for coming to our meeting this time. How are you?
Good, sir.
Good.
Fine.
Okay, alhamdulillah. So, well, we start the absent first. Alif Iksan.
Yes, sir.
Yusuf Bahtiar.
Yes, sir.
Muhammad Fajar Siddiq.
I'm here, sir.
Muhammad Rifki.
Yes, sir.
Iqbal.
Yes, sir.
Lukmanul Hakim.
Present.
Okay, everyone is here, so we just start learning. But can anyone help me to share screen? I have sent the PowerPoint to the group.
Yes, sir, I can.
Okay, please. Thank you, Yusuf. Okay, today we will learn about ICT or information and communication technology. So, does anyone know what ICT is? Anyone know?
Science about technology, sir.
Okay. Yes, you're right, but actually ICT has much broader meaning. So let's move on first. Please, here are some that I will discuss. The first is about definition. Second, how is the history and the development of ICT? And the third, the benefit of ICT. Then the last is Q&A. So let's get started. Next slide. So what is the meaning of ICT? Next. Okay. Earlier, we heard the answer from Alif Iksan that ICT is science of learning about technology. And that's right. So ICT, or information and communication technology, is a science or a learning material that talking about information and communication technology, which are very useful in the industrial and business sector. Besides that, ICT is also very important in the education sector. Why? We will discuss the benefit of ICT for education later. Now we are going to the next page. But how can ICT come into our life? How is the history? Next. Here is the history and how the development of ICT can be occurred. Start from the invention of the telephone by Alexander Graham Bell at 1875. Then the wireless transmission via the first ever AM radio broadcast. And then until now, many developments that have been after 1956. And of course, all this development have been very beneficial for us in 2021. Next. Okay, now I'm going to show you the benefit of ICT for education. First is increase educational equality, and then facilitate and provide broad access to education, then it can increase the effectiveness and efficiency of management and administration of educational institution. And the last one is improve the quality of learning between teacher and student. And that is some of benefit of ICT for education. Next slide. Okay, so after what we learned earlier, do you have anything to ask?
I'm sir.
Okay, please, Maulana Fikri.
What should we do that ICT always be used?
Okay, thank you. So the question is, what should we do so that the ICT can always be used? Okay, let me answer the question. As students, as well as ICT user, you must be able to take advantage of the advantage of ICT and try to reduce the impact of the weakness of ICT. With that, ICT will always be considered positive and can be always be useful in our life. Like that, do you understand?
Understand. Okay, understand, sir.
All right. Any other question? Nothing. All right. Maybe that's all for today. I hope you can learn something about ICT, and we will meet again in another day. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima kasih, sir.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, yeah. Yo, boy.